Want to learn how to do Walt Disney World on a budget? Find out how on this week's episode of the Theme Park Hipster Show. Hey, Theme Park Hipsters, it's your host, NikkyJ, the owner of ThemeParkHipster.com, where I help you plan the best solo theme park vacation with the latest tips, reviews, personal stories, and more. Today, I am going to go over some things to help you save money before and also while you're at Walt Disney World. But first, I want you to definitely go ahead and get your free Walt Disney World itinerary ebook that you can download instantly in today's show notes. Now, there are ways to enjoy Walt Disney World without having to break the bank. And you know that I am here to plan that epic solo theme park vacation, but I'm also here to help you save money too. Walt Disney World can be done in so many ways on an effective budget. That's if you know what to do. Today, I'm going to go over 17 tips to make sure that you are saving the most at Walt Disney World. And I'll definitely be sure to link the full article on today's show notes. That way you can go ahead and go on the website. You can save it to your phone or you can go ahead and print it out for later. The first thing you're going to want to do is to remember to shop around for the hotel that you choose. Hotels that are off-site throughout the Orlando area are definitely less expensive than staying at the Disney resorts. But on the flip side, staying at the Disney resorts will give you special perks such as free transportations that will replace the price of having to rent a car or get random cabs or Ubers or Lyfts. The next thing you want to do is to book a vacation package with your ticket. Through authorized Disney vacation planners such as Destinations in Florida, I had Laura on where she talked about what Disney vacation planners do. They can definitely keep an eye out on all the deals that Walt Disney World is doing. Plus, if you do get a Disney vacation planner, they are free. And most of the time, that vacation planning includes all of your reservations. It'll include your fast passes and your Disney theme park tickets. Tip number three is to use professional or club discounted rates. If you're part of a professional organization or a travel club, always check to see if they have any theme park discounts. Dental, pharmacy, AAA are just a few examples of organizations that may have theme park ticket deals just for you. AAA usually has a significant discount on Walt Disney World tickets, so that's another place for you to check. Tip number four is to stay at an all-suite hotel with an in-room kitchen. This is important because it gives you the chance to save on your dining budget. You can go grocery shopping, and based on the planned out meals, you can do breakfast and dinner at your hotel or vacation rental, and then you can do lunch at one of the parks. Just have it all mapped out and have your daily food budget set, and you will be on your way. Tip number five is to look for flights leaving on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, or Saturdays. Those days tend to be the cheapest days to travel, and booking your actual ticket on a Tuesday mid-afternoon around 3 to 4 p.m. has been said to be the best time to book flights. The industry is usually updating prices, and for some reason, personally, I've been lucky when it comes to booking flights during that time. Tip number six is to check local travel agents for Disney discounts and deals. And as mentioned before, there are travel agents out there or authorized Disney vacation planners that can help you secure those one-of-a-kind Walt Disney World tickets. They can help you also plan out your whole trip, and they usually know what deals will work best for your situation. So if you want someone to talk to, I will leave a link to Laura at Destinations in Florida in today's show notes. Tip number seven is to purchase the multi-day park pass. I recommend that you get a multi-day park pass ticket that is about 1 to 2 days short of your total vacation length. And what I mean is, if you will be staying at Disney for 4 days, maybe look at booking only 2 days to go to the park. So on the first day in Orlando, you may be too tired and jet lag, and you can use that day to explore Disney Springs or just stay at your resort and explore your resort, hang out at the pool. You can read all that at Theme Park Hipster. I have a whole article breaking down how to do a whole Disney vacation, and it's called The Ultimate Disney Planning Guide. You can find that on Theme Park Hipster. Tip number 8 is to do free or almost free activities at Disney World. There are so many things you can do in Walt Disney World that is free or very, very, very low cost, such as viewing animals at Animal Kingdom Lodge. You can do resort tours where they'll take you around the resorts and give you explanations of how the resorts are made, maintained, some history, some hidden gems. There's also something called the Campfire Tales that you can experience at Fort Wilderness Campground. Those are activities you can do, and those can replace things on those non-theme park days to kind of help make your money last a little bit. Tip number 9 is to take advantage of Disney freebies and souvenirs. Not only can you do some free activities, but you can collect items such as celebration buttons, trading cards, stickers. You can do art classes at Disney resorts, and you can get samples of soda at Epcot. These are all things that you can take advantage of, and they are absolutely free. Tip number 10 is to use discounted travel sites for hotel deals. If you don't go through someone like a Disney authorized vacation planner, then use a website like hotels.com, which also has great deals for you. And here's something you should know. Hotels.com has this reward system where if you book 10 hotel nights through their website, you'll receive one night free. So if you've been staying at hotels before your Disney trip and you're about to hit that 10th hotel, or you have hit that 10th hotel, you can use that free night at one of the Disney hotels on your vacation. I've done this before, guys. It totally works. It's simple. If you're already booking hotels before your vacation, why not try hotels.com? Tip number 11 is to book a vacation to Walt Disney World during the off season. Be sure to check out the Disney crowd calendars to help you determine the best time and the best season to book your Disney vacation. Personally, I recommend early November or mid-January. This is where the crowds are at their best and the weather of Florida is at its best. You'll also be able to maximize your days and you'll be able to really enjoy the whole property offered by Walt Disney World. Tip number 12 is don't forget about a vacation home rental. A vacation home is another great option where you can get a wonderful deal on lodging for your Florida vacation. I recommend Top Villa. They are one of the best vacation home rental organizations out there, and they house so many vacation homes right near Disney World that can beat out any resort, hands down. This is one of my favorite things to do, is to have a staycation at a vacation home. And if you've ever followed me on Instagram, you know I love my staycations, especially at vacation home rentals with resort amenities. These places such as the Encore Resort or CLC, Regal Oaks over in Kissimmee, they are some top-notch vacation home rental resorts. Tip number 13 is to research dining options at Walt Disney World. The dining options at Disney can be overwhelming. It is very important to plan out what you want to eat at each theme park. You want to also have an idea of what's on their menu. If you plan on having lunch there, then decide where you want to eat and possibly, if you can, what you want to eat. This will definitely help you with planning your budget out and making sure you stick to your budget. Tip number 14 is to bring your own snacks and water. Having snacks and water will hold you over between your meals. And water in general is just very important to have at Florida because of the severe summer heat and humidity. But be sure that your snacks are within Walt Disney World guidelines, because sometimes it can be kind of tricky. Just try to do things like chips, or you can do a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, things like that that won't get you flagged. Definitely you can't bring any alcohol inside the parks. Tip number 15 is to purchase Walt Disney World souvenirs off-site. You can use websites like Amazon, or check this out. You can go to the Disney Outlet Store, which is in one of the outlet malls right next to Walt Disney World. And this place is amazing for Disney souvenirs. You can usually get a Disney souvenir that sometimes is in the park at the same time for 50 to 80% off. this place is where I get all my souvenirs. You will not find me buying anything in the parks, souvenir-wise, because I know I'm going to get a better deal at one of the Disney outlets. Also, another tip to know is that if you check some of the local stores in Orlando, like a Target or a Walmart that's near Walt Disney World, they usually have Disney t-shirts that are there for significantly less price. Tip number 16 is to buy ponchos, water, and sunscreen prior to your visit. Don't get caught up in the Disney rain and the Disney $20 price of a poncho. A lot of the items can be found, such as ponchos and sunscreens and water, can be bought at Dollar Tree for as little as a dollar. And I'll leave that link too. I'm going to leave these links because this is how you can do Disney and not stress out about your budget. Tip number 17 is to use discount websites for cheap Orlando activities. If you've ever thought, okay, well, I'm not going to get that full 4-day park experience, or I can't really afford it, there are other things that you can do inside of Orlando that is not just Disney or a theme park. They're fairly cheap and they usually have some great deals on Groupon. Some of the activities that I recommend are like some of the golf locations, the put golf locations around Orlando. You can also do like tree climbing adventures, kind of like where you do go on like these little obstacle course at Orlando Tree Trek. That's a place I've been to. It is amazing, terrifying, but amazing. And they're usually all within a great price. Like I said before, Groupon has great deals for this. And I will leave a full article of things to do in Orlando besides theme parks in the show notes. That is it, guys. We just went through 17 powerful tips to get you through Disney on a budget. And in case you don't remember, I'll go through them quickly. Tip number 1 is to shop around. Tip number 2 is to book a vacation package with your ticket. Tip number 3 is to use professional or club discounted rates. Tip number 4 is to stay at an all-suite hotel with an in-room kitchen. Tip number 5 is to look for flights leaving on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, or Saturdays. Tip number 6 is to check local travel agents for Disney discounts and deals. Tip number 7 is to purchase the multi-day park pass. Tip number 8 is to do free or almost free activities at Disney. Tip number 9 is to take advantage of Disney freebies and souvenirs. Tip number 10 is to use discounted travel sites for hotel deals. Tip number 11 is to book a vacation during the off season. Tip number 12 is don't forget about a vacation home rental. Tip number 13 is to research dining options at Walt Disney World. Tip number 14 is to bring your own snacks and water. Tip number 15 is to purchase Disney souvenirs off-site. Tip number 16 is to buy ponchos, water, and sunscreen prior to your visit. And tip number 17 is to use discount websites for cheap Orlando activities. Hey guys, we have completed this episode of the Theme Park Hipster Show. I hope these Disney saving tips helped you all, but I want to know which one was your favorite. Be sure to let me know over at the Theme Park Hipster Facebook group. I want to chat with you. And if you have some other tips that were left off, we want to know them too. So definitely hit us up at Theme Park Hipster Facebook group, or you could just connect with me over on themeparkhipster.com. Don't forget to get your free Disney Game Plan ebook, and you can find the link in the show description today. Thank you so much for taking the time to listen to the Theme Park Hipster Show. You are my friend and you are my family, whether you know that or not. And until next time, happy park hopping, hipsters. The content on the Theme Park Hipster Show represents my own and not those of any organizations or activity mentioned. I am just someone here who likes to share my own stories to you and hope that I can help you have the best vacation ever.